Hello everyone, my name is Ashray and I'm part of the Azure Identity Advanced Cloud Engineering team within Microsoft. As an admin, you may want to export your AD Connect's configuration for different purposes, like upgradation of your AD Connect or just to keep a backup of it for later usage. Let's see how that can be done through the AD Connect wizard. Open the AD Connect wizard on the server from where you would like to get the configuration and let's click on Configure here. In this screen, we see an option that allows us to view or export current configuration. Select that and click on Next. This screen shows some of the basic configurations of the AD Connect instance. For our purpose, let's select the Export Setting button in here and save it in a known location. This essentially exports out a JSON file that contains most of the configurations of this AD Connect server, which can be imported later when you install a new AD Connect server. Next, let's take a look at how this file can be used to import the settings. In this server, I'm trying to set up a new instance of AD Connect as a staging server. For that purpose, I've already copied the configuration file we exported earlier to this location in the server. While running the Azure AD Connect installation tool, let's go with the custom installation option by selecting the customize option. In this window, we see that there is an option to import synchronization settings. Selecting that will allow you to browse to the location where you have your exported configuration file and select it. Some settings aren't imported from the configuration file, and these are the settings that you have an option to override in this page, like the use of SQL Server instead of LocalDB or use of an existing service account instead of default virtual service account. Once you're ready, click on Install to let the wizard install the required components. By default, the User Sign-In page has a sign-on option that was selected in the server from where you exported the configuration file. If you see the need, you have the ability to change that for the server here in the screen. The Connect to Azure AD page shows the account that was used by default to configure the original server with Azure AD. In this page, where you see the connected directories, you will need to re-enter credentials to either create a new synchronization account or supply a pre-created custom sync account. This is identical to the clean install experience, with the exception that you can't add or remove directories through this flow. In the Configure section, you have the option to start a sync cycle and also to choose whether you want the server in staging mode or not. In here, the staging mode is intentionally enabled by default to allow comparison of the configuration and sync results before actively exporting from the server. I hope this video helps you in understanding how you can export and import AD Connect configuration. Thanks for watching.